हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ग्रेड अप, इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट लाइव लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म। सही प्रेप है तो लाइफ सेट है। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। तो इन दिस ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम कैप्सूल 6, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट RRCPU शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिथम, दैट इज राउंड रॉबिन CPU शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिथम। तो लेट स्टार्ट। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। माई नेम इज़ अंशुल शर्मा। I have 1+ years of teaching experience and mentoring GATE CS aspirants. In GATE 2020, I have secured All India Rank 294. I have also qualified ISRO and NILET exam. My area of expertise is operating system, digital logic, compiler design, DBMS, discrete mathematics, and computer networks. So those who want to subscribe to GradeUp Super, those who want to prepare for GATE 2022, so you can subscribe to GradeUp Super for Vision 2022 English batch, for Vision 2022 Hindi batch, and for Vision 2023 Hindi or English batch. For all these streams, it is available. So in this batch, you are going to get 850 plus hours of live classes, 8000 plus practice questions, 120 plus mock test, and 100 plus chapter wise study notes. So you can subscribe to GradeUp Super, and for more information, you can contact on this number 965005290. So those who want to connect with me, they can join this Telegram group as well. So the link is Anshul_Sharma_CS. So you can join this group for all the PDFs of YouTube classes, doubt clearances. So you can ask your doubts as well as you can get the guidance related to the GATE preparation if you want any. So let's start round robin CPU scheduling algorithm. So in this algorithm, the criteria is time quantum and arrival time, right? So this is based on time quantum and arrival time, and the mode is preemptive here. That means you can preempt the process in between as well. So here we are assuming that it is given to us time quantum is equal to 2. Okay, time quantum is given in this question that it is 2. So let's understand how we are going to schedule these processes using round robin CPU scheduling algorithm. Suppose we have 6 processes here, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, and P6. So arrival time is given to you, burst time is given to you. Now you have to find out the completion time, the turnaround time, waiting time, and a response time for all these processes. Now here, we are going to maintain one queue. We are going to maintain one queue, right? And we are going to prepare the chart to schedule the processes. Now here, carefully see, at 0 units of time, at 0 units of time, which of the process have arrived in the ready queue? You can see P1 process has arrived in the ready queue at 0 units of time. So I can, this is your queue. So you can write here that P1 process has arrived. Now you can schedule P1 process, right? So you have to schedule the P1 process. So you have to compare the time quantum and the burst time of that process. So here you can see time quantum is less than the burst time. So you have to schedule P1 process for that time quantum, that is 2 units. We can make it 2. So whichever is less, you have to compare the time quantum and burst time. Whichever is less, you have to schedule that process for that particular amount of time. Now you can see at 2 units of time, we have P2 and P3 as well present in the ready queue. That means here we can write P2 and P3. P1 we have executed for 2 units of time, so we can dequeue it and we can again enqueue it in the queue here. Now it's time to schedule P2 process. Right, so P2 process, you can see the burst time is 5, time quantum is 2. Whichever is less, you have to schedule for that amount of time. 2 plus 2, it is 4. Here we can make it 3. Clear? Now at 4 units of time, you can see P4 and P5, they have also arrived. So you can write P4 here and P5 as well, right? And you can dequeue P2 process and you can enqueue it again. Here, now at 4 units of time, we have to schedule P3 because next is P3 in the queue. So we have to schedule P3 process now. Now you can compare time quantum is equal to burst time. That means you have to schedule for 2 units of time. So 4 plus 2, it is 6. We can make it 0. P3 has completed its execution. We can just dequeue it here. Now at 6 units of time, P6 process has also arrived. So I can write P6 here. Now it's time to schedule P1 process again. So here the remaining burst time of P1 process is 2 and the time quantum is also 2, both are equal. So let's schedule it for 2 units of time, 6 plus 2 it is 8. We can make it 0, P1 has completed its execution also. So we can dequeue P1 process from now. Now we have P4 process next in the queue, so we have to schedule that. The burst time is 1 and time quantum is 2, so whichever is less you have to schedule for that amount of time. 8 plus 1 it is going to be 9. We can make it 0 and P4 has completed its execution as well. We can just dequeue it. Now it's time to schedule P5 process. So you can see P5, the burst time is 2, time quantum is burst time is 6, time quantum is 2. So whichever is less you have to schedule for that amount of time. 9 plus 2 it is 11. We can make it 4, right? And we can dequeue P5 and we can enqueue it again here. Now the next process is P2. So we have to schedule P2 now. The burst time is 3 and the time quantum is 2. So whichever is less, schedule it. 11 plus 2, that is going to be 13. We can make it 1. So dequeue P2 and again enqueue it here. Now it's time to schedule P6 process. So burst time is 3, time quantum is 2. So we have to schedule for time quantum. That means 13 plus 2, that is 15 here. We can make it 1. We can dequeue it and we can enqueue it again. Now it's time to schedule P5 process. So the time quantum is less than the burst time. So we are going to schedule for 2 units of time. 15 plus 2, it is 17. We can make it 2 and we can dequeue it and we can enqueue it again. Now it's time to schedule P2 process. So the burst time, remaining burst time is 1. So we have to schedule for 1 unit of time only. 17 plus 1, it is 18. We can make it 0. P2 has completed its execution. We can just dequeue it here. Now we have to schedule P6 process now. The remaining burst time is 1. So let's schedule it for 1 unit of time. 18 plus 1, it is 19. We can make it 0. P6 has completed its execution. And we can dequeue it. So in the end we have just P5 process now. So let's schedule it for the remaining burst time, that is 2. 19 plus 2, it is going to be 21. We can make it 0. P5 has also completed its execution. We can just dequeue it here. Now according to this chart we can write the completion time. So the completion time of P1, as it is preemptive, so scan from the right hand side, right? So the completion time of P1 is 8. The completion time of P2 is 18. The completion time of P3 is 6. The completion time of P4 is 9. The completion time of P5, it is 21. And for P6, it is 19. Now we can find the turnaround time. Turnaround time is completion time minus arrival time. So 8 minus 0, it is 8. This is 17. This is 4. This is 6. This is again 17. And this is 13. We can find the waiting time also. Waiting time is turnaround time minus initial burst time. So this is going to be 4. 8 minus 4, that is 4. This is going to be 12. This is 2. This is 5. This is 11. And this is 10. Now let's talk about a response time. So we know response time is first time CPU allocation minus arrival time of that process. So you can see here the first time CPU allocation happened for P1 at 0 units of time. So 0 minus arrival time, that is also 0. So here we are going to get 0 response time for the P1 process. For P2 process it is 2, 2 minus 1 it is 1. For P3 it is 4, 4 minus 2 it is 2. Then for P4 it is 8, 8 minus 3 it is going to be 5. Then for P5 it is 9, 9 minus 4 it is 5. And for P6 it is 13, so 13 minus 6 it is going to be 7. So you can see now you can find the average turnaround time, you can find average waiting time, average response time as well. So you can see in this way we can schedule all the processes using round robin CPU scheduling algorithm. Clear? So that's it. And these are the star faculties we have at GradeUp for computer science courses. So you can join GradeUp and you can prepare for GATE 2022 or 2023. In GATE 2021, we have 10 plus gradients under AR10 among all the streams. That is a big achievement for GradeUp and its students. If you subscribe to GradeUp Super, you will be getting unlimited access to structured life courses. Green card is also included in this. So India's best faculty, complete doubt resolution, full syllabus coverage for your exam, 100 plus online mock test designed by the toppers based on the latest exam pattern. For more information, you can contact on this number 965005294. You can also install GradeUp app, so you can attend all the free app classes which we are conducting daily on GradeUp app, and you can also attend free mock test, right? All over India, you can get the ranking also. So you can install this GradeUp app from Play Store. And thank you everyone for joining this. I will see you in the next video. Till then, take care and bye-bye.